Have you ever wondered why the rules for adding and subtracting with significant figures are different from multiplying and dividing? Well, the answer might not be very satisfying, but here we go. Remember how significant figures are a representation of the precision in a measurement, or uncertainty depending on how you look at it? Well, it's not a very good representation, to be honest. For example, 12.3 and 1.23 both have three significant figures. But when it comes to looking at the amount of precision or uncertainty, are these two numbers really on par with each other? Let's add them using the rules for addition and subtraction with significant figures. First, you identify the least precise measurement of the two and its place of uncertainty. That'll be 3 in 12.3, since 12.3 has its uncertain digit 3 in the 10th place, while 1.23 has its uncertain digit in the 100th place. Next, you add or subtract. Well, you'll have to make sure that your answer doesn't misrepresent the precision of your measurement. You do this by making sure your answer doesn't have more digits below the place of uncertainty in the least precise number. Since the least precise number, 12.3, has its uncertainty in the 10th place, you'll have to truncate below the 10th place and round up or down. Don't know if you noticed, but the number of significant figures itself was never used during this process. All we did was look at the place of uncertainty in the least precise number and just draw a line down next to it. The reasoning behind this is that when you add or subtract, you know exactly where the uncertainty lies in the final answer. In our example, the uncertainties in 12.3 and 1.23 will be transferred to the 10th place and the 100th place respectively in 13.53, and we'll end up with two places of uncertainty. Given the situation, smart people decided it was good enough to truncate the final result so as to leave just one uncertain digit. Hence the rule, identify the place of uncertainty in the least precise number and match it. The truth of the matter is, calculating with significant figures is just an exercise of how much imprecision we can live with. Addition and subtraction is fairly straightforward since we know where all the uncertainty lies. But what about multiplying and dividing? When you multiply or divide, the uncertainty scatters all over the place. Kind of like how pus flies all over the place when you pop a pimple. For example, let's multiply 12.3 and 2.3 and see what happens. Because the process inherent in multiplying, the uncertain 3 in 2.3 is multiplied with the digits 1, 2, and 3 in 12.3 respectively, and placed in the 1s, 10s, and 100th places of the final answer respectively. Then the uncertain digit 3 in 12.3 is multiplied with the digits 2 and 3 in 2.3 and placed in the 10th and 100th places of the answer respectively. As you can see, the uncertainty gets scattered all over the place and we can't just draw a line down like we did in addition and subtraction. So smart people decided, instead of trying to figure out where all the uncertainty went every time, they just decided that counting the number of significant figures in the number with the least amount of significant figures and matching it was good enough. We don't know if good enough was the answer you were expecting, but that's science. Sometimes our measurements just suck. Deal with it. Stick science.